Yesterday we discussed about the corrosion. And now we know, or we already know, corrosion changes the desired properties of a metal. Right. Corrosion will change the desired properties of a metal. Then, how can we prevent a metal surface from corrosion? How can we prevent corrosion? Oiling, actually, okay. Oiling, sariga painting, essentially, painting. Okay, when we apply oil or when we paint a surface, paint a metal surface, it can prevent the direct interaction between moisture so that corrosion will be prevented. Have you heard about galvanization? Galvanization or sacrificial protection? Yes. What was that? Sacrificial protection or galvanization? What was that? Extra layering, yes, sir. We have to provide a deposit of metal, a metal deposit on the metal surface that will be corroded. And how can they select the metal deposit, the metal used for depositing on the metal surface? Iron surface ne protect cheyanengil iron de thanne metal deposit namaku pattillalo. So how can we use or how can we select which material is suitable for coating? Ede material aanu ee iron surface ne protect cheyan corrosion ninnu protect cheyan use cheynathu adu namaku engane kandupidikkam? Reduction potential materials diyan. And you are familiar with electrochemical series. In electrochemical series, electrodes are arranged in the increasing order of reduction potential. And for saving a metal surface from corrosion, we can select the metal to be pasted on the surface based on galvanic series. ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസിന്റെ അപ്ലിക്കേഷൻസ് അപ്ലിക്കേഷൻ ആയിട്ടാണ് ഇത് വരുന്നത്. ഏത് മെറ്റൽ യൂസ് ചെയ്താൽ ഒരു മെറ്റൽ സർഫസിനെ കൊറോഷനിൽ നിന്ന് പ്രൊട്ടക്ട് ചെയ്യാം. യു ക്യാൻ സെലക്ട് ദ മെറ്റൽ ഫ്രം ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസ്. ആൻഡ് ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻഡിക്കേറ്റ്സ് റിലേറ്റീവ് കൊറോഷൻ ടെൻഡൻസി ഓഫ് എ മെറ്റൽ ഓർ അലോയ്. അലോയ് മീൻസ് മിക്സ്ചർ ഓഫ് മെറ്റൽസ്. When exposed to seawater at specific temperature for a specified period of time. So you have some metals and you are exposed metals to seawater and you know the temperature. And it is kept in seawater for a period of time. And you are changing the corrosion tendency of each metal in that condition. And based on that, you are arranging those metals in a galvanic series. So based on galvanic series, we can select which metal is suitable for preventing corrosion from the iron surface. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു മെറ്റൽ, അതിപ്പോ അയൺ സർഫസ് ആണെങ്കിൽ ആ അയൺ സർഫസിനെ പ്രൊട്ടക്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ ഏത് മെറ്റൽ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നു എന്നുള്ളത് ഈ ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസിന് മനസ്സിലാവും. അതെങ്ങനെയാണ് മനസ്സിലാവുന്നത്? വെൻ ടു മെറ്റൽസ് കൺസിഡർ Fe and another metal are immersed in an electrolyte, and if they are connected by a conductor, then less noble metal experiences galvanic corrosion. You know, noble metals will not react. So when we connect iron and another metal, let's assume as zinc, you have iron and zinc, and you are immersing those metals, iron and zinc, in an electrolyte. And these metals are connected by a conductor. And it is exposed to seawater, and you are measuring its corrosion tendency. Then you can see there, zinc metal will corrode fastly compared to iron metal. നിങ്ങളുടെ കയ്യിലുള്ള അയൺ മെറ്റലും സിങ്ക് മെറ്റലും ആ രണ്ട് മെറ്റലിലും ഏതിനാണ് കൊറോഷൻ ടെൻഡൻസി കൂടുതലുള്ളത്? ഹൗ കൻ യു ചെക്ക്? ഫോർ ദാറ്റ് യു ഹാവ് ടു കണക്ട് സിങ്ക് ആൻഡ് അയൺ മെറ്റൽ യൂസിങ് എ കണ്ടക്ടർ. ആൻഡ് ദ ലെസ് നോബിൾ മെറ്റൽ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഹിയർ ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസിനെ ഓർഡറിൽ നോക്കിയാൽ നമുക്കറിയാം അയൺ ആണോ സിങ്ക് ആണോ ലെസ് നോബിൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ളത് എന്ന് ഈ ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസ് നോക്കിയാൽ അറിയാം. ആ ഗാൽവാനിക് സീരീസിന് അയണിനേക്കാളും ലെസ് നോബിൾ ആണ് സിങ്ക്. സോ ഇഫ് യു ആർ കണക്ടിങ് ദോസ് ടു മെറ്റൽസ് സിങ്ക് വിൽ ബി കൊറോഡഡ് ഈസിലി ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ പ്രൊവൈഡ് എ പ്രൊട്ടക്റ്റീവ് ലെയർ ഓവർ അയൺ മെറ്റൽ. So if we are depositing zinc layer on iron surface, we can protect iron surface since zinc will corrode easily compared to iron. So based on the arrangement of metals or alloys in galvanic series, we can select which material is suitable for preventing corrosion from a for a, any surface for any surface. Okay, in this module you have come across with you have come across me two series, electrochemical series and galvanic series. In electrochemical series, electrodes were arranged in the order of increasing reduction potential. In galvanic series, the metals or alloys were arranged in the order of their corrosion tendencies. How can we prevent corrosion? Using cathodic protection. Which surface will corrode? Means, is it anode or cathode? ഈ കൊറോഷൻ നടക്കുന്ന ഇലക്ട്രോഡ് ഏതാണ്? ആനോഡ് ആണോ കാഥോഡ് ആണോ? Yes, it is. It is anode, you know. Then, if you are converting an anode to cathode, we can prevent corrosion. If you are converting anode to cathode, we can prevent corrosion. Since corrosion will happen in the anodic region. There is basic principle behind cathodic protection. Here, it is an electrochemical method for reducing corrosion on metallic structures when it is exposed to electrolytes. And these electrolytes include sodium and water. When a metal is exposed to electrolyte, when it comes in contact with electrolytes, which includes soil and water, there will be corrosion. And if we are applying cathodic protection, it will reduce the corrosion. It is an electrochemical method. Then, how can we apply this method? Here, we are providing electric charge to the metal surface. We are providing electric charge. Or we are providing electrons using an external source. Then by providing these electrons, the anodic region or the metal surface will convert into cathodic. In cathodic protection, there will be elimination of anodic sites, means the metal converts itself into cathode, and conversion of entire metal into cathodic. So, in short, cathodic protection is an electrochemical method used for reducing corrosion. And here we are applying, we are providing electrons using an external source. Using these electrons, the entire metal gets converted into cathodic. Hence, it will be protected from corrosion. Is it clear? What is cathodic protection? If you have any doubt, or ഞാൻ ഇത് റിപ്പീറ്റ് ചെയ്യണം എന്ന് തോന്നുന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ പറയണം കേട്ടോ. Then electroplating. You may know about electroplating. Electroplating. This is electroless plating. You may have heard about electroplating. Have you heard? Electroplating is a term. This is electroless plating. I chose electroplating. Okay. Both in electroplating and electroless plating, we are depositing a metal on the surface of iron or steel. We are depositing metal on the surface of iron or steel to prevent from corrosion. But there is a difference between electroplating and electroless plating. And we are focusing on electroless plating. In electroless plating, we are not using electricity. In electroless plating, we are not using electricity. So what is this? What do you mean by electroless plating? It is a method of depositing a metal from its salt solution on a catalytically active surface of the metal to be plated using a suitable reducing agent without using electrical energy. What are the important terms? It is a method of depositing metal from its salt solution. If we have to deposit nickel, if we have to deposit nickel on iron surface, we need its salt solution. We are depositing nickel from its salt solution. So this is about the nickel. Then about the iron surface. On a catalytically active surface of the metal to be plated. This is about the iron surface. It must be catalytically active. The iron surface must be catalytically active. And we are using a reducing agent. The process does not use electrical energy. In short, if we have to deposit nickel on iron surface, we have to take a solution of nickel ions. That's the salt solution. A solution of nickel ions, and our iron surface, it must be catalytically active, and we need a reducing agent. We are not using electricity. This is what known as electroless plating. In generally, we can define this method as method of depositing a metal from its salt solution on a catalytically active surface of the metal to be plated using a suitable reducing agent without using electrical energy. And what is the need of this reducing agent? Why do we use reducing agent? Why do we use a reducing agent? We have a salt solution. Solution containing nickel ions. And we need to deposit nickel on the iron surface. We have solution containing nickel ions. And we need to deposit nickel on the iron surface. Then we need to reduce the metal ion. Reduce Ni2+. Then only it will convert into Ni, which is to be plated. നമ്മൾ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് നിക്കൽ അയോണിന്റെ സൊല്യൂഷൻ ആണ്. നിക്കൽ അയോണിന്റെ സൊല്യൂഷനിലേക്കാണ് അയൺ സർഫസിനെ ഡിപ്പ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഈ റെഡ്യൂസിങ് ഏജന്റ് യൂസ് ചെയ്യാതെ നിക്കൽ അയോണിനെ നിക്കൽ മെറ്റൽ ആയി കൺവേർട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ കഴിയില്ല. നിക്കൽ മെറ്റൽ ആയതിനു ശേഷം മാത്രമേ അത് അയൺ സർഫസിലേക്ക് ഡെപ്പോസിറ്റ് ചെയ്യുള്ളൂ. That is why we are using reducing agent for the reduction of metal ion into metal. Given here, metal ion when reacting with reducing agent gets reduced into its metal, and there will be a byproduct. And this electroless plating, it is an autocatalytic process. You may have heard about catalysis. You are familiar with catalysis, right? Catalysis, catalyzed reactions. Yes. Why do we use catalyst? Why do we use a catalyst? Increase rate of reaction. And see, it can also decrease the speed. So we have to specify both. Okay, and see, it can be used for sariga rate of chemical reaction. Kutanulla korakkanum use cheyya. There is positive catalyst and negative catalyst. Okay, we can alter the speed of a reaction. It can either increase or decrease the speed of the reaction. To alter the speed of a reaction. Here you may see this is an autocatalytic plating. Autocatalysis means one of the reaction product. One of the reaction product will act as the catalyst. One of the reaction product will act as a catalyst for the reaction. That is autocatalytic reaction. Reaction product itself can act as a catalyst. Then, how can we plate a nickel? Plate nickel on any other surface. ഇനിയിപ്പോ പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ നിക്കൽ അയൺ കണ്ടെയ്ൻ ചെയ്യുന്ന സൊല്യൂഷനിലേക്ക് അയൺ സർഫസിനെ ഡിപ്പ് ചെയ്യുകയാണ് ആ അയൺ സർഫസിന്റെ മുകളിൽ ഒരു നിക്കൽ കോട്ടിംഗ് വരുന്നത്. ഇനി അതെങ്ങനെയാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്? വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഇലക്ട്രോലൈസ് പ്ലേറ്റിംഗ് ഓഫ് നിക്കൽ? ഹിയർ we are depositing nickel phosphorus alloy on a surface. In electrolysis plating of nickel, we are depositing nickel phosphorus alloy on surface. Electrolysis nickel phosphorus plating, it is a chemical process that deposits an even layer of nickel phosphorus alloy on the surface of a solid substrate. It can be metal or plastic. So through the process, we are depositing nickel phosphorus alloy on a solid surface. For the process, there are two steps. For electrolysis plating of nickel, there are two steps. The first step, preparation of the surface, pre-treatment and activation of the surface. Through the process, we are cleaning the surface. Through pre-treatment process, we are cleaning the solid surface. And we have to activate the surface. This step is the first step in electrolysis plating, pre-treatment and activation of the surface. In the first step, we have to remove oil, dirt, grease, etc. from the surface. We need to remove oil, grease, dirt, etc. from the solid surface. For that, we are using organic solvents or alkali, and it is followed by acid treatment. This is how we can clean the surface and make the surface catalytically active. And depending on the solid surface, We use different solvents or alkali. If we have stainless steel, steel surface like on a nickel coating, surface steel surface only, we have to dip that surface. We have to dip that surface in hot solution of 50% diluted sulfuric acid. And if we have magnesium alloy, if it is the surface, then we have to provide a coating of zinc and copper. Nickel plating chain. Our surface magnesium alloy aanki. Our surface like zinc and copper day or coating aanki. Angareyaan our surface in the pre-treatment activation of chain. Then copper, aluminium, alloys like brass. Surface nickel coating chain surface. It's okay. There is no need of activation. And if the surface is plastic or glass, we have to dip the surface in solution containing stannous chloride. Stannous chloride, SnCl2. And HCl, hydrogen chloride, or hydrochloric acid. Followed by dipping in PdCl2, palladium chloride. Pd for palladium. PdCl2, palladium chloride solution. So based on the surface, we need to treat it with different organic solvents or alkali. Then it is followed by acid treatment. This is the first step in electroless treatment. Then what about the second step? Now we have cleaned our solid surface. Then we have to immerse that cleaned solid surface into a plating bath. We are immersing the cleaned surface into a plating bath. That plating bath consists of many number of chemicals. That plating bath consists of number of chemicals, and they have their own functions. Each chemical present in plating bath has its own functions. For nickel plating, we are using nickel chloride, and it provides a coating on the metal surface or the solid surface. ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞിരുന്നു നിക്കൽ പ്ലേറ്റിംഗ് ആണ് നമുക്ക് ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് നിക്കൽ അയോൺ കണ്ടെയ്ൻ ചെയ്യുന്ന സൊല്യൂഷൻ ആണ് യൂസ് ചെയ്തത്. നിക്കൽ ക്ലോറൈഡ് കണ്ടെയ്ൻസ് എ 9+ അയോൺസ്. ഇറ്റ് വിൽ പ്രൊവൈഡ് എ കോട്ടിംഗ് ഓൺ ദ സോളിഡ് സർഫസ്. ദെൻ ദ റെഡ്യൂസിംഗ് ഏജന്റ്, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് സോഡിയം ഹൈപ്പോഫോസ്ഫേറ്റ്. സോഡിയം hypophosphate is used as the reducing agent, and it is used for metal deposition. We know using a reducing agent we can reduce metal ion into metal. So sodium hypophosphate is used to reduce nickel ion to nickel. Then for quality improvement, we are using a complexing agent, sodium succinate. It is used for quality improvement of the reaction. And for maintaining pH, we are using a buffer, sodium acetate buffer, for maintaining the pH. So now, in the second step, we have immersed our cleaned surface in the plating bath, and the plating bath consists of these ingredients. Each ingredient has its own function. Then let's check what will be the reactions happening in the plating bath. This is how reaction will happen at each electrode. We are immersing the pre-treated means cleaned surface in the plating bath for a required time. And these are the reactions that will happen at each electrode, at the anode. At the anode, we know oxidation will happen, reducing agent, that is sodium hypophosphate, will get oxidized. Sodium hypophosphate, it will get oxidized, and there will be loss of electrons. H2PO2- hypophosphate ions gets oxidized, and there will be loss of electrons. At the cathode, reduction will happen. Ni2+ nickel ions accept electrons and get reduced to nickel. This nickel will deposit on the solid surface. This nickel will deposit on the solid surface. And we can write the net reaction. Ni2+ plus hypophosphate ions plus H2. On the plus side, H2PO3, H+, and Ni will be on the right side. So in this reaction, we can see the metal ion Ni2+ on reacting with reducing agent get reduced. Ni2+ gets converted to Ni. And the reducing agent gets oxidized. This is how nickel is plated on a solid surface. Clear or not? What is electroless plating and the electroless plating of nickel? Repeat it now. Repeat it now, clear or not? Okay. What are the applications of electrolysis plating of nickel? അതിലുള്ള പോയിന്റ്സ് ഒന്നും നമുക്ക് മനസ്സിലാവാത്തത്ര ടഫ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള പോയിന്റ്സ് അല്ല, സിമ്പിൾ പോയിന്റ്സ് ആണ്. നിങ്ങളൊന്ന് വായിച്ചു നോക്കിയാൽ അതിൽ ഏതെങ്കിലും ടഫ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു പോയിന്റ് ഉണ്ടോ? ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻസ് ഓഫ് ഇലക്ട്രോലൈസ് പ്ലേറ്റിംഗ് ഓഫ് നിക്കൽ. They are used in electronic applications, used in domestic automotive fields, and it is used in ABS plastic. ABS plastic, it is a copolymer, and we have to understand its preparation, and it is given in module 4 about ABS plastic, ABS copolymer. I think those 4 points are clear. Certainly, electrolysis plating of nickel will have some advantages. What is the advantages of electrolysis nickel plating? You know, for electrolysis plating, there is no need of electricity, and it can be carried out on irregular shaped objects, insulators, semiconductors, and the deposits are highly compact and adherent. These are the advantages of electrolysis plating of nickel. Okay. Then attendance are there? Adra.
Present ma'am.
Abhijit.
Present ma'am.
Abhijit KP.
Present ma'am.